You're struggling with your timing? Let's talk about some tips that can help you with your timing. I'm Natasha Watley, two-time Olympian, and I help softball athletes become game changers. I'm so happy that you landed on my page. Make sure if you want to hear the best softball, slap hitting, tips, drills, motivation, make sure you subscribe to my channel, you follow me, you like my page, do all of the things so that you can be notified every single week that I put out a new video. So the biggest thing with timing, it's the most frustrating thing because it is always going to be a struggle. Whether you're 7, you're 37, you're gonna have to figure out timing when you're facing a pitcher. That's gonna be the hard part. The reason being is because every pitcher has a different motion, every pitcher has different pitches, and on top of that, we've got to make sure that we are on time. But that's the thing that remains constant, the things that we need to do to set ourselves up to make sure that we are on time. So here are some tips. The first thing is thinking about starting on a pitcher's descent. So when we talk about their descent, every pitcher is gonna get to the top of her motion and come down to her descent. So when the pitcher gets to her descent, she's about to release this pitch, that's when I wanna start thinking about my first step. Now, what's going to differ from pitcher to pitcher is the speed of the pitcher. So the slower she is, I'm going to wait a little bit later. Remember, I just said you wanna think about your first step when she gets to that descent point. But once she releases the ball, if she's a slower pitcher, then that's when I wanna start to take my first step. If she's a faster pitcher, then probably when she hits that part of her motion right on her descent, that's when I'm going to start that first step. So a big tip to remember whenever we are talking about our first step or we're talking about timing, late is on time. That is so important to remember. We would much prefer to be later than to be earlier. Because why? We want to make sure that we are late, we're hitting this ball to the left side of the defense. So the main thing that we are trying to time is we want to make sure on that crossover step that we get that foot to plant, then we're making contact. So we want that to be like a 2 heartbeats. We want to be step, make contact. Step, make contact. So that's what we're timing for. So what we don't want is we don't want to be stepping and sitting here waiting and the pitch hasn't even been delivered yet. It's going to be crucial that you're waiting at the last moment that you possibly can to start, because why? Late is on time, my friends. So a good drill that you can do for working on timing is have someone throw you front toss and have them change the speeds. So they're gonna kind of dictate on when you're gonna start that first step and when you're trying to time that crossover step. So have someone throw you super quick, have the ball get on you super, super fast, because then I'm going to have to start my steps a little bit earlier. Also, have somebody throw you some changeups or have slower speeds, because then I want to make sure I'm starting as late as possible so that I can let that ball travel. So I would love to invite you to join my live class on how to build a game-changing triple threat. You don't want to miss it. Classes are October 1st, 2nd, and 3rd, and we're going to talk all things timing. So you want to make sure that you are there live to check it out. Make sure you go to gamechangers.natashawatley.com/triple-threats. Can't wait to see you there. If you like this video, make sure you like, you share, you comment. Let me know what you liked about this video. Let me also know what other videos you want to see. I love making these videos for you guys. I hope you enjoy them as much as I love making them. And I will see you next time.